Hey guys, Banana Luck here, and welcome back to another Watch Your Realms video. So today we're back with the Boreas, Arbiter of Wrath Immortal Codex Challenge. We've done the training in the previous one, just in case any of you guys get stuck if you're still very early on to the game, but let's look at the boss before we actually attempt this for the first time. So when a hero applies a buff by casting skills, they will be frozen permanently. All heroes' revival time increased by 60 seconds. Dealing continuous damage to the Arbiter of Frost or his Cryo Core, heroes restore their HP, he has high physical and magic damage reduction, and heroes all gain attack speed and restore increase of HP when they deal continuous damage. I'm not sure what this means. Yeah. Let's see, do extra damage, increase continuous damage, and then Cryo Core, which must be destroyed. And yeah, this is just his damage mechanism. So I am gonna change Corridor's kit. Just wanna get more damage in on him. Not sure who to change actually. I think I'll change it from Zilitu, because I don't use Zilitu anywhere that, you know, might be detrimental. I do use Corridor for my. Okay, gonna do Arrogance at the furthest point because he only does his burning on range. Do this, this, and then Corridor, and Kilk. Yep, I think we're fine here. Might have to do the Salazar out because I need to build up that. I think that's his weakened state, I hope. I have no idea actually. Yeah, destroying that claw like crazy. Most of my units are quite down though. They are not recovering as many HP as I would have thought. Maybe I do need to switch the artifact on what do you call that? Corridor. Because Torridor has that Defender's artifact which can give him some regen. Yeah. I think that has to do with me not timing the ultimates properly on Valeria. Probably a timing that we'll have to get a hang on. You see the respawn time is increased, so you really need to make sure that you keep your units alive. Still doing well in terms of keeping up with the poison and the burns that are required. Corridor dies because we don't have the artifact to keep him there alive. This is gonna be close. I think we might not actually get it. Yeah. Okay, Valeria is back. Oh, nice. Don't think we're gonna make it for this. We lost our Kilk. Kilk definitely needs more HP there. This is not going to be a very good run. Let's see what the damage was looking like. See where we're lacking. Okay, Salazar Arrogance actually doing decent damage. I think the problem was them dying when we started to struggle with the core. I'm honestly not sure if Valeria is actually super good here. Yeah. I might consider swapping in Zilitu instead. Yep. Or maybe even Last. Because Last does do burning with her ultimate. Yeah. Let's try that instead. We'll swap in Last. And swap the gear back from Valeria. And I think the extra reach does help everyone, so it's probably going to be more beneficial. And we definitely need to level our cube. Let's do this. First time I'm probably gonna ever see someone focusing on kill. Okay. Do some promotions if we can. Okay, that's nice. And just gonna replay this and hopefully get better results. Oh no, we forgot to swap out. Who is that? Corridor's artifact, yeah. I think a struggle with using Lars is that she might not survive as well. I don't know how it works, but yeah, I think Valeria self-sustains with her own talent. So that's gonna be a big difference. Let's do the tuning crystal here and I'm gonna swap back to. Okay, we'll just try Lars for one go and see how that goes. See if it's any good. Two arrogance down, last, Deimos. So you definitely need some self-sustain going on. Like what we had earlier alone was not enough. Lars is having her HP drop slowly but surely. I don't see where the recovery is coming from. But they said that and the two tips that you'll get recovery if you hit the boss. Okay, I think it's coming in now. But is it enough? That's the problem. Let's hope things don't fall apart like how they did earlier. Okay, it's gonna be starting to get a bit close. Lars actually survives, yeah. And Valeria just had that ultimate timing earlier. Now this is the one where we might not actually make it. It's gonna be close. Okay. Yeah, this is gonna be either super close or we're not gonna make it. Not gonna make it. Yeah. It's just one stack though, so it doesn't kill, like, I think the stronger units, but it kills the ones that are weaker, but... Auras definitely does significantly more damage now. Last man standing. We'll be underestimating how much, you know, the reduction to, you know, normal physical damage is. Let's see how much Lass is doing, just to get an estimate of whether or not this is going well. Lass is doing decent, actually. So, I don't know. Is the boss too strong, or am I doing something wrong? Let's check rankings. So not the whales, though. I'm actually in third place, wow, yeah. Fiona doing decent work, she actually is. Arrogance, my arrogance is doing... let's say. Yeah. Doing slightly more Zilitu, maybe we should swap in Zilitu instead. Let's see who is doing the least here. Deimos is doing the least, so let's do this instead. We'll swap out Deimos. Get Zilitu in, and let's just make sure that we get the good gear on him. So the gear is on Torador. Now we just need to swap Torador gear with somebody else. That's gonna be Silas, and let's see if this works better. Because I think the burning is really what's doing the damage. Feels good to be wreaking havoc on Boreas. So arrogance. Zilitu. Oh, Zilitu doesn't have self-sustain though. That might be a problem. Let's keep the ultimates for when the extra damage is being done. Especially when it comes to Zilitu. As it is just gonna take a while to regenerate her rage. That's gonna be the main drawback, I think. And having her at A3 will make a lot more sense. If they did how they do sticks, where if you destroy the core you get some rage back, I think then yeah. Zilitu might really be quite in meta here. The thing is that burning stacks from multiple sources, so it's actually good if you can stack it up. That's why we have Lass here, because Lass does burning when you have her bonded with Arbiter. My Zilitu's gonna die, he needs to regenerate. Okay, that's coming back up. Make it. Yep, pretty close. Okay, we might not make the next one, because we got Zilitu's out. Nope, doesn't look like we're gonna make it. Zilitu dies, unfortunately. That's last. Just finishes. fall starts to really hurt in the later bits. I think maybe a bomb could do good here. It does do burning. Yeah. Is Salazar just single-handedly surviving through the whole thing? It's nothing. Let's see. Yeah, Zilitu doesn't do that well, actually. I think the other contender will probably be Hex, if you want to look at it. But yeah, it's rank 4 for now. Probably take some time for the mana to evolve and see what works best, but this guy Zilitu is doing a lot better, but it's A5. Okay. That's probably the main reason why, because she gets more ultimate uptime compared to me. Yeah. And I'm also seeing quite a lot of people are using Cube, but this guy is not. So maybe Cube is not really that great. Yeah. Maybe we'll try it without Cube once. We'll do it with Elowyn instead. See if that actually gives us more uptime with our ultimates, which means that we actually get more damage off. Same thing. We'll do it this way so that we position our healers. Do it this way instead. See how it works better. So that way we ensure that they don't die, but at the same time we also get courage of those folks. Because I'm doubtful how much the poison is doing. But yeah, the damage will tell after this. I don't think Dolores will make a big difference because it's only gonna amplify the damage. Like, I don't think it amplifies burning damage, or maybe it does, but it doesn't amplify the bleed damage or the, you know, poison damage for sure. So maybe having Elowyn here instead might be better. Okay, now it's just making sure that Zilitu gets ultimate in time for the next wave, which should be rather close. I know the last time around I didn't make it. Yep, now we make it. And now the problem is Zilitu's ultimate is running out. Might not be enough for the next uptime. Yeah, I can't place anything down either. Ah, so close. Okay. They actually all survived because there's a healer. Okay, he's gonna cast his ultimate again, and that's gonna be a problem. Because we're definitely not clearing it again. Actually, not that big of a difference in terms of damage difference, because at the end of the day, being able to break his cryo core is the most important thing. Using Hollow might be better. So maybe let's try that.
beast will find a way.
Hello. See if it does me back. Because they all do take damage, so that means that Hollow regenerates way faster. And let's see if... Okay, just block... Having Zilitu block actually does more damage. So... I'm considering getting her in front instead of having Corridor there. Yeah. Follows ultimate.
Wait.
This gets the ultimate up again. The cube might have been oversold by me, unfortunately. Doesn't look like he's that good, actually. We're gonna get the next bout of ultimates, which is nice. So we've managed to clear this. Get down close. The real big question, can it come before the next wave of ultimates? Okay, it doesn't look like it's going to. But yeah, at least they survive. I'm gonna get a slightly better score than the last time, but it's not that big of a game break. Yeah, that's probably enough testing for today as to what works and what doesn't. It'll probably take some days for the mana to develop or decide what works best, but yeah. Okay, so that's a score and 42 million, Zilitu doing a lot more now. Salazar. Yeah, I think the one lacking in damage is actually Corridor. So, probably lots of improvement that we can do, but that's gonna be it for the video today. Rank 5. That's not gonna stay for sure, but yeah. And start to see sort of a strategy forming up. And this guy is doing great work actually, with just a rough as lot. This cube is doing great work too. I might consider actually taking out Corridor. I'm not sure how helpful he is. From the perspective that, okay, but those double hits will ensure higher bleed uptime, so. But that's gonna be it for the video, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I hope it was helpful, and feel free to leave any questions you have below, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.